Today we're talking about the character of my mother, Rahmatullah Aliha, Nafisa Ahmed Muhammad Gracie. Nafisa was one of 13 children born to my grandmother. Unfortunately, 10 of them died. And only 3 of them were alive. My auntie, my late auntie, my late uncle, and my mother. In the 30s, actually, the business of my grandfather was in seeds, selling seeds for the food, and barley, wheat, and maize, and others. And the business was flourishing, and he was looking very well after his 2 sons, my uncle Hassan and my mother Nafisa. He used to take them everywhere, buying the best dress for them, the best clothes for them, taking them to the theater and even the cinema when it was open to show them the other side of the life of Cairo at that time. My grandfather was originally, as I mentioned, from Munafiya, from a place called Ashmoun Grace, but they moved the whole family to Cairo. At that time, he was one of the political supporter or the activist of Al-Wafd party, which was the main political party in Egypt. And my mother was a member of Al-Wafd party, and she was one of the people who deliver speeches, especially in an area called Darb al-Ahmar at that time, in the 30s. The business of my grandfather became downhill at the time of the recession after the Second World War, which is from 35 to about 45, or let's say to 45, which affected very much Egypt, unfortunately. And my mother was a very sociable character, community leaders. And when she was young, she was offered a place in something called medical school. At the time, it was a boarding school. And she was sleeping in the boarding school at that time, but my great-grandfather came to my grandfather from my mother, Ahmed al-Gracie, and was very upset how on earth his young granddaughter sleep outside the house. And they pulled her out of this medical school at that time, and she was waiting for her marriage at home like any other girl at that time. But she was a very good reader, reading history book, culture book, yani poetry, religious, theology, everything. And the good thing about her, then when there's a meeting in our house, and my father's on this side, and she's on this side, and they discuss a religious issue, she was always arguing with him about her opinion on how this has happened, like as the greatest destruction of the fitna, which is Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu, and Sayyidah Aisha, and others. And she was a very good reader of the history book, like Al-Jabarti book, and every day she used to have to read the books, dramas, and others, plus the newspaper every day. But she was actually always defending herself, her opinion, in front of everybody. And even my father, as a soft character, used to smile at her and tell her, actually, Ya Sheikha or Ya Hajja, thank you for your opinion. And he never actually dismissed her opinion and or her argument to him. When I was born, she discovered that I had the polymyelitis in my leg, and she was frustrated, and she was trying to treat me at any cost, but there was nothing to do at that time. It's gone, خلاص, there's no vaccination in Egypt at that time. And she used to implant in my heart how to love to play sport and run and play football and others. And she's the one who led me to be a member of the scouts groups at that time. We used to go to camps here and there. And she used to come with me to buy all my clothes. I was spoiled as a young boy at that time. So she was very careful to try to compensate what happened to me, and thinking that this is because of her. No, it's not because of her, it's because actually the lack of vaccination to the children when they were born at that time. So when we remember the warm life between my father and my mother in the house, and the character, the leading character of my mother in the house, and the house was divided in 2 parts. My father was very busy reading the theology part and his business of actually reading and the books, the old text, Islamic textbooks, and she was actually looking at the social side of it. So people want to get divorced, want to get married, or get money, and all this used to come to the house to the Hajjah at that time. So this impacted me very much in Al Halmiyyah and outside Al Halmiyyah, and when we moved to the other house. And believe me, that actually the age of the childhood up till the 14 is the age when everything is counted and printed at the back of the mind of your child. And this is why I'm still remembering these stories which impacted my life up till today. May Allah bless their souls, both of them. And thank you very much for watching the video. I wish that you can activate the notification bell and share the video with your colleagues and channel friends. Assalamu alaikum.